Welcome to our channel. This video wholeheartedly created by botany student of Immaculate College for Women, Cuddalore, affiliated to Annamalai University. The mission of the college is to empower young women to face the challenge of modern culture and society with courage and commitment. Learn, light and liberate is the motto of the college. This video is based on the study of fossil plants and types. Next, we are going to see paleobotany. Paleobotany is the study of fossil plants. A fossil plant is the remains of traces of a once plant. Fossil plants are generally found buried below ground. It is scientific study of ancient using plant fossils found in sedimentary rocks. The father of paleobotany is Birbal Shagni. Next, history of paleobotany. Paleobotany has a long history in the world of science. Plant fossils are usually easily recognizable and people throughout the world have been finding and collecting them for hundreds of years. What kind of plants might a hungry dinosaur have eaten? When did flower first appear on Earth? How did plants contribute to the formation of Earth's current atmosphere? All these questions and many more can be answered by the scientific field of paleobotany. Next, types of fossilization: impression, compression, cast and molds, permineralizations and molecular fossils. Impression: two-dimensional imprint devoid of organic matter, most commonly found in fine-grained sediment such as slit or clay. Compression: two-dimensional fossils with organic material. Compression retain organic matter, usually more or less qualified. Cast and molds: three-dimensional fossils may have a surface layer of organic material. Cast and molds commonly lack organic matter, but a resident structure may be preserved as a compression. Permineralization: three-dimensional tissue infiltrated by minerals, allowing internal preservation. Permineralization occurs when the plant tissues are infiltrated with minerals-rich fluid. Molecular fossils: non-structural fossils preserve organic compounds. Some carbohydrate breakdown products may also survive in sediment. Next, fossil formation. In layers of sedimentary rock, organism is buried by sand, dirt and sediment. Over time, as more and more layers build up, the bottom layers become hardened throughout pressure. Study fossil in laboratory. The following points highlight 6 main sophisticated techniques which are employed these days to study the in laboratory. The techniques are ground thin technique, peel technique, transfer technique, maceration technique, X-ray technique and macrotomic technique. Next, importance of fossils. Examination of fossils over its history show the evolutionary of lifetime through. Because fossils show a continuous change through time and no fossils disappear and reappear later. They can be used to give relative ages of fossils. Bearing strata: strata bearing the same fossils assemblage can be correlated. Fossils indicate environment of deposition. Fossils can constitute most of a rock. Next, nomenclature of fossils. The whole plant is not preserved, but only detached plant parts like stem, root, cone, leaf, etc. preserved as fossils. These detached plant parts are being discovered in different times by different authors. Each detached organs or fragments is given a different name. Each of this name acquires the status of a genus. The generic name in fossils is applicable only a plant-like root, stem, leaf, cone or other organ. Next, objectives of paleobotany: to understand different form of plants, to understand the interrelationship, plant ecosystem interaction, role in altering food chain, plantation management and wildlife management. Next, scope of paleobotany. Plants are a fundamental part of life on Earth. They generate the oxygen, food fibers, fuel and medicine that allow higher life form to exist. Evolution of plants have changed the global atmosphere of Earth early in the Earth's history. Plant response to ultraviolet radiation can help us monitor problems like the ozone depletion. Paleobotanists study ancient plant in the fossil history. Conclusion: study of fossils have been given a data about the past life on the Earth surface. By studying these fossils will help in understanding the evolutionary trends in life. The fossil studies give the key to the past environment. Thanks for watching this video. We think this video is very useful, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe.